Hey you guys, it is Sunday, the day before the caucus. We are here walking towards Hyatt Elementary School. This is where my kids go, or middle school. This is where my kids go to middle school. And we're gonna go see Joe. The bus just left. You can see it's all the way over there. This is a big event. This is an event before the
caucus
tomorrow. Our one last hurrah. We were going to park since we were just live not that far away. But no, it has been so busy.
Yeah. Yeah.
That looks awesome.
Yeah, are you going to get through?
Okay, so there's a dumb Trump guy. You see him?
Or I want to grab this bag and break it.
Okay, so I guess we gotta go the opposite way. Press is, I don't know if you could see that dumb guy back there, but a guy had his driving the tractor with Trump all over it. Saying 4 more years, but we know that's not gonna happen.
Trump?
Oh, no. Look at all these parking. Normally we don't have this much parking, like the array of the school when we're picking up the kids from school. So we are walking all the way. I think the main entrance is probably where we have to walk. News media. I see CNN. Our local news, but I've seen also some other states.
I found a black
I should have worn my caucus pants and shirt, but I didn't. I just have my Todos para Biden shirt. Let me flip this over. So Nayeli came with me and Dulce and Emma. I don't know who's ahead of us, but they're speaking a different language. So we're expecting to see a lot of news media, a lot of people from everywhere. This is the first in the nation caucus. This is like the last, well, not the last, this is like the first decision. Look at the line. Letty, there's Sebastian. Can you see them walking this way?
So
walk up my
All right, you guys, so guess what? I just got interviewed by this guy from the Washington Post. I'm gonna tag him in this video. I should have got a picture with him, but maybe I will tomorrow because he's gonna fly on my Tuesday. He's gonna fly on my airline. So we have news media all over us, saying hi, videotaping us. Miley doesn't want anything, but you know, we're gonna vlog them.
That's what she's saying.
Go on.
Hawaii.
See, look at all these people. Look at this one. I am so excited, you guys. Let's say, how do you feel?
How do I feel?
Yeah. So what do you think? Are you excited to talk about this? Are you excited to visit CJO? Is this your first time? Nayeli, how many times have you seen Joe? Okay.
Five?
I don't know. This is, I think, our fourth time. Do you have a pen? Oh, you have a pen so you can sign.
Yeah, I know. Did you guys see that? There's people over here taking pictures.
I'm vlogging, so I'm going to show you. Yes, I seen him and he was like, we're going to give 4 years. But you know, that's why he came into town to, Trump came into town.
Of course, yeah. He needs to keep his behind it on.
Hey, look, it's Joe Biden, because I
this state is talking endlessly.
No, it's funny, because it's like, why, he doesn't come to Des Moines often, and all of a sudden he's here wanting to cause trouble. He's a bully.
Yeah,
that's what bullies do.
That's exactly right.
They said, I guess there's going to be a lot of, like, some protests at the when we caucus, like in our caucus station.
Really?
So.
Probably so.
Yeah.
I caucus here 1 year. I only live a block away. But I go to East.
Oh, that's where I.
Really?
Yeah.
Are you in the cafeteria?
I don't know where I'm at.
There's a library and a cafeteria.
I have to check that out. Okay, so I was just interviewed with a guy that was from the Herald, Dante Camacho. So remember that name. I'm going to see where we're going to sit.
Everybody else, please come this way.
I'm going to have you go straight from it. Are you by yourself?
I'm with my daughter. There's four of us. So go this way.
This first row is for 88, so they have to go behind. Okay,
we're gonna go this way.
Which way?
They want us to sit in over here. There's four of us?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah. All the way by the flag.
There's also space.
Yeah, she said by the flag. Should I cut this way or what? Okay.
Perfect.
Do you mind just sneaking under?
Yep.
Fill in the holes if you don't mind.
Do you want to go that way, maybe? Alright, we'll switch. Here, we're going to scooch this way, probably. Here on the bleachers. Is Emma this way? Are you guys excited? Alright, I'm gonna flip this over.
That's the only size I got.
No, it's
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, Des Moines. My name's Connor. I'm a field organizer here on the east side of Des Moines, and I want to thank you all so, so much for coming out on Super Bowl Sunday. And thank you for coming to something even more important to the Super Bowl. It's the Super Bowl of politics. It's the Iowa caucuses. Thank you so much. So, for the last 2 months, I have had the privilege of living in your community, talking to you about your concerns, your thoughts, and your hopes. And I've loved every single minute of it, so thank you for making me feel at home here. And, you know, I'll be honest, I honestly am still kind of surprised that I ended up here. Coming to Des Moines, being an organizer for Joe Biden was never, ever my plan. My plan for my life was always to go to law school with my best friend, Roger, and, you know, to become lawyers together. Roger is a very good friend of mine. He lives in Chicago. He's a fourth generation member of his union, and he's my best friend in the whole world. But unfortunately, that didn't happen. What's up? Sorry about that. So, all right, can you hear me now? So sorry about that. I was just saying, I'll speed it up. I always wanted to be a lawyer with my best friend, Roger, who's a fourth generation member of his union. Yeah, absolutely. Unfortunately, that did not happen. Right at the end of last year, my best friend, Roger, was diagnosed with kidney cancer at the age of 21. And when I went on to graduate, he had to drop out of school. He's working full time to pay for his medical expenses. And it was a really, really dark time for me personally. And in that dark time, Joe Biden's message brought me a feeling of hope that I hadn't had in a long time. So, he brought me a message of hope when I was stuck feeling extremely, extremely powerless. So what I did is I came here to Des Moines, and I came here to fight for a president who's going to stand with our unions like Rogers Union. He's going to fight for our health care, like the Affordable Care Act, so that instead of being forced to drop out of school, Roger can afford his health care. So I want nothing more than for him to be standing by my side right now. You know, I've often had to think about how different this country would be if we had a president who was simply as compassionate and as caring as Joe Biden is. That's what I think about when I go home from work. And I'll be honest, I really thought we were going to get that in 2016. I was so confident in 2016 that I didn't actually do anything to make sure that it happened. And to this day, I still remember the feeling in the pit of my stomach that's unlike anything I've felt in my entire life. And it's not something I'm sure you all remember. It's not something you can forget. So that's that feeling that motivates me every single morning when I go to work. And what I want is in November of this year, I want a feeling so good that I never forget how good it felt, because Joe Biden is going to be our president. What makes Joe so unique is that he knows exactly what we need to do to clean up the mess that's in our White House right now. He has been there before, and he knows exactly what to do to set it right. He knows how to fight for working class people, people like my best friend Roger, because he has a proven track record of fighting for them, fighting for people who are paying their way through school, fighting for people who are fighting to pay their medical bills. He's fought for women's rights, he's fought for gun control, and he has won every time. So what we need to do is send a winner into this general election. And we are working very hard here in Iowa to do it. Tomorrow's the big night, and we have a chance to set a new path for our country going forward. We have an amazing team here, literally hundreds of precinct captains, dozens of whom are here today to celebrate all the work that they have done, all the thousands of calls, all the thousands of door knocks. So thank you to our volunteers. And so my ask to you is that you just emulate them and you spread the word far and wide about the good work that Joe Biden is going to do. There's too much at stake for you to not spread the word. You'll look around my coworkers.
Thank you. I'm Valerie Biden Owens, and I just want to start out by saying that it has not been easy raising an older brother. A brother of mine, I'm going right to heaven. It is a great time to be here and to celebrate with you that our future President of the United States, Joe Biden. Campaigning for Joe is something that I've done, I guess, my entire life. I believe in him today as much as I did when he won that first election for class president. You know, Joe has said, you've heard him talk about that we're in the battle for the soul of America, and it's a soul that's been...
Hey, you guys. So I'm on my way to work. It is 3 o'clock a.m. So while you guys are still partying up KC's Super Bowl win, I am on my way to the airport. So I just want to get on here real quick. Hey, so I'm on my way home. I just got off of work. I have about 2 minutes to do this video because I think I'm running out of storage. Just to reiterate what I was talking about this morning, we did go to a Biden event. It was the last event till the caucus, which is today, Monday. I think I have to be there by 6 o'clock. But today, excuse me. So besides all that event this weekend, today's a busy day for me. Today and tomorrow is a busy day for me. I work for somebody today.
And then I have to rush to the doctor's appointment or doctor's office to get paperwork that I need. We have our second foster care assessment, our home visit today. And so I need to rush and get that, go home, make sure the house is straightened up, cleaned or whatever. And she's coming at two or at one. She's coming at one. And I have to make sure all that's done. Make sure I have all my paperwork ready. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go to the doctor's offices right now, get those done, hurry up and rush home. Yesterday went fine. The Biden event, we did not stay the whole time because we had a birthday party that we had to head to. But we were able to see Joe's sister speak, which I recorded a little bit, and one of our really good friends that is helps out and volunteers, he's one of the field organizers on the east side of Des Moines. We saw him speak, which I was so proud of him. So proud. So that is it. I'm gonna end this here, and I will see you guys later.